Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I'm starting a new video series, how to set up Elk Stack on Kubernetes environment. This is first video in this series, how to set up Elasticsearch on Kubernetes cluster. Let's begin. I'm using the Helm chart to set up the Elasticsearch on Kubernetes. This is the official Helm chart repository for the Elasticsearch. We are going to modify values.yaml file to set up the customized Elasticsearch environment. This file is starting from cluster name. My cluster name is Elasticsearch. This is the node group. This is going to be a address of Elasticsearch service in a cluster, which can be accessible by other Elk service like Kibana, FileBeat, MetricBeat, etc. You can run Elastic service or server in a cluster. These values help to determine how many replicas going to be run for the Elasticsearch and what is minimum count of the Elasticsearch master machine. I am running only one instance of Elasticsearch because I am using the local persistent volume. This is volume claim template. Access mode will be RWO. Read many, write once. This is storage class name and size will be 5 gig. I am using the local persistent volume claim for the Elasticsearch. It is going to be create a service type cluster IP. I am using the ingress. This is host name for Elasticsearch service. I am not using TLS or SSL certificate. This is default backend of the ingress service. Leave the rest of parameters as a default. Now let's create persistent volume for the Elasticsearch. I am using this YAML file to create PV and PVC. Volume mode, file system, read many, write once, access, persistent volume reclaim policy will be retain instead of delete because I am using the storage class on local disk and local disk or volume does not support delete reclaim policy. It supports only retain policy. This is going to be a storage class name, local storage. This is path of persistent volume on Kubernetes nodes. This persistent volume is going to access from both the node worker 1 and worker 2. I am creating a storage class manually and volume binding mode wait for first customer. I am also creating a persistent volume claim. Read many, write once is a permission and this is storage class name. You can use the storage on NFS or any cloud provider. The setting in this file will be changed according storage provider. Let's create the persistent volume. Let's create a namespace for the Elk stack. I have copied both the file on the machine. Let's create PV, PVC and storage class. Persistent volume storage class persistent volume claim has been created. Let's verify. Elk persistent volume has been created. PV claim also created. It is in pending stage until unless first pod doesn't create in Elasticsearch deployment. Let's verify the storage class. The storage class also created. Now we are ready to deploy Elasticsearch. We are using the Helm to set up the Elasticsearch. This is official Helm repo for the Elasticsearch. you require to add this ham repo. I have already added this repo. You can list down ham repo. You can update your ham repo. It's done. Now I'm installing the Elasticsearch by using the ham chart. This is the name of ham deployment. I am creating this deployment in a ELK namespace, and this is my customize values.yml file. Let's go ahead and create it. It has been completed. Let's look at the ports for this deployment. It is in initialization stage. Let's look at the events of this pod. You can see here warning message, readiness health check is failed because Elasticsearch cluster is not ready, because Elasticsearch pod takes some time to come up online. Now you can see here Elasticsearch pod is up and running. It takes some time to come up online. Let's verify the events. It is still showing a warning, unhealthy ports, but ports of Elasticsearch is up and online. Let's look at the PVC. PVC successfully bounded with first Elasticsearch pod. Let's look at the ingress service. This is the ingress host name or URL for the Elasticsearch. In the backend, it is pointing to Elasticsearch service. I am pointing elasticsearch.domain.com to one of the node in Kubernetes cluster. Let's try to access Elasticsearch service on the browser. Yes, Elasticsearch service is working fine. This is tagline that makes sure Elasticsearch is successfully installed and configured, you know, for search. In coming videos, we are going to install a complete ELK stack. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.